So class, today we will look at the remaining questions of trigonometry, very few that remain. And I had asked you to complete these questions as homework. So what we are going to do now in the current session is, once again, I'm not going to tell you the complete solutions. For each of the questions, we will see how many right, how many of you could complete, right? And based on that, I will also give you some more hints if required, even if not required, so that you can see how I would have solved it and how you have solved it. Okay? And if you want me to solve any question completely, that also is possible. So please be ready with your maths two textbooks, notebooks, pens and pencils. Beginning now. So yesterday we solved two questions, question number 6 and question 7, which were the word problem. One was about height and one was about distance. Similarly, there were three more questions, questions 8, 9 and 10 in the textbook, which are word problems about height and distance from trigonometry. So question number 8 reads as, two buildings are in front of each other on a road of width 15 meters. From the top of the first building, having a height of 12 meters, the angle of elevation of the top of the second building is 30 degrees. It is 30 degrees. What is the height of the second building? So clearly, if you have been solving the questions, if you have been attending the class, you will know that we have already solved similar questions. So quickly, can you tell me if you have tried and if you have completed this question on your own, can I see a thumb up? 1, 2. Shubham Singh has shown a thumb up. Shubham Singh, can you please send me a photo of your solution? I would really encourage you not to lie. Not to lie to me, not to lie to your friends, not to lie to your parents. That's not nice. But if you have completed it, very good. This was a homework question. I'm very sorry to say, I'm very sorry to see that only two people have shown me a thumb up. That means only two people have completed it. So what I'm going to do now is, I'll tell you how I would have solved, but I will not solve it completely. I will draw the diagram and then I will wait for you to think about it, to try solve it right there in the class currently. Match your answer with the answer that is given in the textbook, the value, and see if you are able to do it or not. Is it clear? Whatever I am telling you, are you able to hear me, see me? Okay. So it says there are two buildings in front of each other. So if we draw the two buildings, maybe we can draw like this. This is one building. This is another building. And we can call these two buildings AB and CD. It also clearly says that the buildings are of different heights. The buildings are of different heights. It says the buildings are in front of each other on a road of width 15 meters. So this is 15 meters. BD is the road. AB is a building. CD is another building. They are on the opposite sides of a road in front of each other. Right? From the top of the first building, having a height of 12 meters, the angle of elevation. That means the first building is shorter. So AB, the height is given as 12 meters. And it says the angle of elevation to the top of the other building. This angle is given as 30 degrees. This angle is given as 30 degrees. And from here, what is asked is, what is the height of the other building, CD? We have solved this question, this type of question before also, where we said, let this be, this point be X or E. And then we saw a quadrilateral, a right angle triangle. And using that, we solved the question. I'm waiting for you to try and tell me if it is okay, if it is not okay, if you need more hints. And then we will proceed. waiting for your responses. So I will leave the final solution to you, but I will leave you with this information that quadrilateral ABDX, quadrilateral ABDX will be a parallelogram, will be a rectangle. So DX will be 12, AX will be 15. Now you can find CX, find this, add it to 12, and you will find the height of the building. This is how we will have to calculate. Next question, question number 9 reads, a ladder on the platform of a fire brigade. Fire brigade is that vehicle that carries a lot of water. There is a water tank on it, and it goes to wherever there is a fire, and they try to extinguish the fire using water or other chemicals. They extinguish the fire. So a ladder on the platform of a fire brigade van can be elevated at an angle of 70 degrees to the maximum. Ladder means CD. So fire brigade ke jo CD hai, usko 70 degree tak hum usko seedha kar sakte. The length of the ladder can be extended up to 20 meters. The length of the ladder itself is 20 meters. If the platform is 2 meter above the ground, the platform is not on the ground. It's on the vehicle, and vehicle is not on the ground. Vehicle is on a set of wheels, so it is above the ground. Find the maximum height from the ground up to which the ladder can reach. मैंने ये बताना है कि कितने ऊपर तक हम पहुंच सकते हैं using this vehicle, using this fire brigade. A simple diagram can be imagined like this. So a ladder is on the platform. So suppose if I use different colors, suppose this is the platform, right? Which is 2 meters high. Now on this, there is a ladder, and the ladder can be elevated at an angle of 70 degrees. So I can show it like this. This is 70 degrees. And it says that its length is 20 meters. So this is 20 meters. Clearly, we can complete the diagram by imagining the ground like this. And this is the height. This is the height. So if we name this, if we call it A, B, C, D, and E, our ladder is AE. That's only AE. The platform is DE. So platform is vertical, but the ladder is not vertical. The ladder is at an angle of 70 degrees. So the height that the ladder is able to reach will be AC. What it means is this is perpendicular, this is also perpendicular. And the value of sine 70 degree is given here. So using this information, we will have to find the height, AC. Yahi pucha hai na, how far, how high it can go. This is the question. Try, see if you are able to solve. So this first, let us understand that this diagram looks very similar to the, it is exactly same as the previous diagram for the previous question, just that the names and values are different. So what we can say now is BC will be 2 meters, opposite sides of a parallelogram. So BC, we get it. All we have to do now is to find AB. Now you see AB is the opposite side of 70 degree angle and AE is the hypotenuse. Opposite side hypotenuse is sine 70. So using sine 70, if you can write like this, sine 70 degrees equals to AB by 20 equals to 0.94. From here, we can find out AB. BC we know as 2. So the height of the ladder will be AC equals to AB plus BC. That is it. Khadija, got your answer correct. Question number 10, the last word problem of the chapter of the exercise reads, while landing at an airport, landing means something coming down on the ground, coming onto the land. What will land in an airport? An aeroplane. While landing at an airport, a pilot is the person who flies the aeroplane, made an angle of depression of 20 degrees. Right? So to understand this question, we will have to understand how the landing and takeoff works for a plane, for an aeroplane. And it is a little different from a helicopter. What happens in case of a helicopter? Helicopter, if this is the ground, helicopter will take it off. It will take off like this. Land, it will land like this. But in case of an aeroplane, right? Aeroplane will take off like this. And aeroplane will land like this. Please confirm if this is clear. The difference between how the difference in the landing and takeoff maneuvers of helicopters and aeroplane, they're different. Helicopters take off and land vertically, whereas aeroplanes, they don't do it vertically, they do it at an angle. Good. So now we can understand this question. Clearing the screen for you. What it says is the aeroplane, the pilot, takes an angle of depression of 20 degrees. The pilot makes an angle of depression of 20 degrees. The aeroplane makes an angle of depression of 20 degrees. Average speed. Arre, ye speed kahan se aa gaya? The average speed of the plane was 200 kilometers per hour. Trigonometry. He said we will be dealing with height and distance. But this question talks about uses speed, 200 kilometers per hour, and that is why we have a star. The star is there for two reasons. First, to understand how the plane takes off, how a plane lands. The star is also there for us to be aware that this question needs some other concepts also, that is the concept of speed. The plane, so that this is only the average speed. Of course, it must have decelerated. Uska speed dheere dheere kam hua hoga. The plane reached the ground after 54 seconds. See, first it gave us speed. Now it is giving us time. 54 seconds. The question is, find the height. Of course, this is a trigonometry question, height or distance, at which the plane was when it started landing. Remember what we said, the plane will land like this. If it is landing like this and this is the ground, then the angle of depression will be this angle. Now the math should be clear. If you try to draw the diagram, you make an attempt, draw the diagram for this question and send it to me on WhatsApp right now. So I will say let this be the ground in brown color, and just to continue with the color scheme that I have been using, let this be the height of the aeroplane when it started landing. So when it landed like this. When it landed like this, the angle of depression was 20 degrees. Now the angle of depression is equal to this angle, 20 degrees. Alternate interior angles are congruent. Now we can complete the triangle by naming this point as B and the point of landing as C. Of course, no plane lands exactly like this. But this is a simplified version of the real life situation. So the plane started at a point A. It started coming down at an angle of 20 degrees and reaches the point C. Now what is given is the speed of the plane is 200 kilometers per hour, average speed, and it took 54 seconds. Now look at the diagram and tell me what is the distance this plane covered at a speed of 200 kilometers for 54 seconds. What is that distance in this diagram? In the diagram, that distance is clearly shown. We have not calculated the distance yet, but the distance is shown. Identify which distance it is. No, Prachi, that is not the distance. Read the question again and again. The plane is traveling at an average speed of 200 kilometers per hour. It is taking 54 seconds to land. So what is the path that the plane took? And that is why I said, we need to know how the plane lands. Chanda, correct answer. Prachi, now you have corrected your answer. Waiting for others to figure out. Chand, no. Try again. Khadija, correct. Karthik, no. Try again. Try to remember how the plane is landing. If we know how the plane is landing, then we can identify which path the plane has taken. Karthik, now your answer is correct. Clearly, the plane has taken the path AC. So AC is the distance that the plane has covered at a speed of 200 kilometers per hour in 54 seconds. This is the distance. This is the distance the plane covered at a speed of 200 kilometers per hour and in 54 seconds. No Alfia Beta. Akhilesh, Rajesh, you are giving wrong answers. You have not understood. Car agar hota, to car BC travel kiya hota. Car to A pe kabhi hota hi nahi. Once we know this, what we have to do is find the length of AC. We can find now. We know speed equals to distance by time. Speed is given. Time is given. Using that, we can find the distance. If we find the distance, hamare paas hypotenuse mil jayega. The question that is, what is asked in the question is the height. So we can find the hypotenuse using sines. And then we can find the height using trigonometry. Just be careful when you are calculating the distance because the speed is given in kilometers per hour, but the time is given in seconds. Be careful. Either you will convert kilometers per hour to meters per second or kilometers per second, or you will convert time into hours. It is up to you. is completely up to you. I would suggest you complete the speed, you convert the speed into kilometers per second, not meters per second, kilometers per second. Tell me what will be the speed if we convert 200 kilometers per hour into kilometers per second. Kilometers per hour means 200 kilometers by 1 hour. If we have to convert that into kilometers per second, all we have to do is we will say 200 kilometers and 1 hour means 3600 seconds. So when we convert 200 kilometers per hour to kilometers per second, this will be 200 by 3600 kilometers per second. This is first step. Now when we multiply the speed with time, because we know speed equals to distance by time. To find the distance, we will have to multiply speed and time. So our distance, which is AC, will be equal to 200 by 3600 into 54 in kilometers. In kilometers. Now we know the length of AC. We know the length of AC. Sine 20 is given in the value of sine 20 is given in the question. Here, sine 20 means AB by AC. So, write the ratio, do the multiplication, find the length, find the height of AB. That is it. When I see this question, what occurs to me is there is tan and there is sec. There is tan and there is sec. And in my head, the identity that I know, which connects tan and sec, is 1 plus tan square theta equals to sec square theta. This is what I remember. And that is what I will try to use. So this is, I have to start from tan. So tan is on the left hand side. So I will start from left hand side. So LHS is tan to the power 4 theta plus tan square theta. Now I want tan square. So I can clearly see that between these two terms, tan square theta is common. So I can write tan square theta plus 1. What happened here? Algebra happened here. Suppose we had x to the power 4 plus x square. This thing can be written as x square, both have x square in them. So that leaves us with x square plus 1. Right? To do this, we need algebra. Then I can say that this function here will become sec square theta. For tan square theta, I can say, I can take this one to right hand side. I can write sec square theta minus 1. Do this multiplication and you get the RHS. Sec to the power 4 theta minus sec square theta. So remember, we need to use this identity and we need to use this algebra. And this answer is given in the guide. Now in this question, I really don't, the only thing that occurs to me is, on the left hand side, I have two terms. First, on the left hand side, I have two terms. First term, second term. The fractions are terms because they are separated by plus and minus. On the right hand side, I have only one term. So let me start from the left hand side. Now we have two fractions. And if you look at the denominators are different. They are unlike fractions. So we will have to make them like. Making them like, we know the method. We know the method. The method of making unlike fractions like does not change. It remains same, however, the fraction may be. So what we have to do is multiply the fraction with the denominator of the other fraction. So the first fraction we will multiply with 1 plus sin theta. And the second one we will multiply 1 minus sin theta. I'm trying to write properly. Now what remains to be done is complete the multiplication, add the two fractions, and you will get the RHS. Do it on your own. So this question also, we have sec and tan. In this question also, we have sec and tan. So clearly, we will be using this identity. I'm going to write it on the screen once again. 1 plus tan square theta equals to sec square theta. We will use it. We will have to use it. But then even before we use that, we will... In order to use that, we will have to use another algebraic identity, which is a cube minus b cube. Do you remember this identity, a cube minus b cube, or a minus b whole cube? In this one, we have a cube minus b cube. In algebra, we have studied a minus b whole cube equals to a cube minus b cube plus 3ab a minus b. This is the identity we have studied. Using this identity, if we keep this on one side, and we move this term to the other side, a cube minus b cube will be equal to a minus b whole cube minus b DAB, A minus B. If we know this, we can solve this. Next question, which is of the type show or prove, is we haven't solved this question exactly, but we have solved this type of question before. You see what is happening on the left hand side, we have tan theta, sec theta as ratios. On the right hand side, we have sec theta and tan theta as ratio. So remember one of the questions, we can start from either side. If we start from LHS, right, it is given as tan theta by sec theta plus 1, but we want sec theta minus 1. So the way we can introduce sec theta minus 1 is by multiplying the given fraction with that. So I can multiply sec theta minus 1 to the numerator and to the denominator. I do this and then I use the identity 1 plus tan square theta equals to sec square theta, and I will be able to solve. The next show proof question again looks dangerous, tan cube theta minus 1 by tan theta. But it is not dangerous. See, it says tan cube theta minus 1. So what we need to realize here is tan cube theta minus 1 equals to tan theta ka cube minus 1 ka cube. It is a cube minus b cube. It is the same thing. A cube minus b cube. Now, what do we know about a cube minus b cube? Another identity. So one identity was a minus b whole cube. From there we found a cube minus b cube minus 3ab, a minus b. From here we found one identity for a cube minus b cube. There is another identity for a cube minus b cube, which reads as a minus b, a square, ab plus b square. See, think. Do you know this? Have you seen this? Have you learned this somewhere? Have I written it correctly? Have I done it? Have I done something wrong? Check the identity. Or should it be plus? So using this identity, and once again using the identity 1 plus tan square theta equals to sec square theta, we should be able to solve. We should be able to prove. There is no shortcut. This last question is very similar to question number 12. Question number 12 of practice set 6.1. Last question of practice set 6.1. Question number 6, part 12. So here also, we will have to use theorem of equal ratios. Theorem of equal ratios tells us that something that we studied last year. It tells us if A by B equals to C by D, there are such ratios which are equal, then A plus C by B plus D is also equal to A by B and is also equal to C by D. We can also say that A minus C by B minus D, they will also be same. Studied this last year. We wrote it in general form. A by B equals to C by D equals to E by F we said equal to dot dot dot. Then we said this will be equal to, in the theorem of equal ratio, we said A plus MC plus NE plus dot 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 by B plus MD plus NE plus NF, NF plus dot dot dot. Theorem of equal ratio. And along with an identity, that is sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1.